Lee.
Brittany.
Josh.
Rona.
TJ.
Ilana.
Ricky.
Christina.
Mark.
Nita.
Ryan.
Matt.
Nikki.
Tony.
Lindsay.
Tate.
Terry.
Fred.
You.
Welcome to the Mickey Mouse Club.
It's music day, and we're so excited because Brian Mcknight is here.
Yeah, Brian's gonna be doing two really great songs for us. But right now, let's shift into high gear with a song from our MMC concert.
Here's Rona, Ricky, and the gang with a hot song from our album MMC, Real Talk.
What could possibly be more embarrassing than having to go shopping with your mother?
Well,
nothing. We'll show you what we mean.
spiffy for school, Mitch. Hey, do you like these pants, Mitch? Mitch? Oh, Mitch! Mitch! Ah, oh, Mitchell!
Mother, this is really embarrassing. Why can't you just give me some money and I'll shop by myself?
No, because I know what you'll do. You'll bring home like a $60 pair of jeans with holes in them. That is embarrassing. Look at this clearance rack.
I hope no one sees me here.
Mitch! Mitch. Hi, Mitch.
Dawn! What are you doing here?
We're just shopping. Elaine, this is Mitch.
Hi.
You know, the guy I've been telling you about.
Oh, that Mitch. Isn't this guy you wanted to go out? Nice to meet you.
Do you like these pants, Mitchie?
They'll look great on the mannequin, Irene. Why don't you go try to find a matching shirt? Thanks for the help.
Who is that?
She's my ma. My employee. Didn't you know? Yeah, I work here. I'm the assistant manager. Hey, have you seen the men's dressing room? It's a big mess. It's hard to find good help these days.
Well, hey, if you work here, then maybe you can help us pick out some clothes.
You know, I'm really busy. But not too busy to pick out some really cool stuff for you guys. Why don't you guys try this stuff on before someone else does?
Mitch, are those girls friends of yours?
Girls? Mm-hmm. Friends? Oh, no. Just nameless faces in a crowd. I've never seen them before in my life. I don't even know who they are. But enough about them. These pants are great. Let's go.
Wait a minute. You have to try them on.
Oh, no, I don't. I can tell just by looking. They're going to fit like a glove.
I want them to fit like pants, and I am not going to stand here and argue with you about it, Mitch.
Neither am I.
Mitch.
Hey, honey, are you looking for Mitchell?
Yeah. The assistant manager. Have you seen him?
Oh, no, I haven't seen the assistant manager.
Oh, well, thanks anyway, Irene.
Oh, well, why does everyone keep calling me Irene?
See, they fit perfectly. I'll meet you at the cash register.
Oh, no. I want to be sure they fit. All right, sit down. Do you have enough room in the waist? Stand up. No, sit down.
Mom.
Are you sure you have enough room in there?
Mom, there's enough room for the whole family, including Aunt Edna.
The thing that concerns me is the length.
Yo, Spellman.
Oh, no. Mom, Mother, I love these pants so much. Could you find them for me in every color right now?
Oh, see? Aren't you glad I came shopping with you?
I'm so glad.
Spellman, who's your date?
He's probably here with his mom.
Oh, my mom. Not me, boy.
There you are. We love the clothes.
Oh, you look
great. Oh, yes, you
Thank
look
you.
Wonderful. They're perfect, you know?
Thanks.
But you could use some hats. Oh, yes, they're right back that way. You can use some hats. They're so in right now. Go get them now.
Mitch, not one, but two girls.
Yeah. I thought you were here with your mom.
Not me, boy.
Okay, I found them in cinnamon, mango, blueberry, and kiwi.
You know, Irene, you're a great sales lady, but I don't need those right now.
What are you talking about, Mitchell?
Mitchell?
Mitchell.
He really is here with his mom.
Mitch, do you think I need his hat in a smaller size?
Oh, you could really you could ask his mother.
Mother? You mean Irene the sales lady?
Yeah, right.
Irene the sales lady? Oh, of course. Well, that's who I am. Gentlemen, you know what? You guys would probably look great in a pair of these pants. Mango for you. Blueberry for you.
Oh, no.
Don't do that.
You keep that. You're going to be all right with that. No, keep that.
Mitch, are you going on lunch break?
Yeah.
Well, how would you like to join us for a burger?
I'd love to.
Great. We'll meet you up front.
See you there. Mom, you're the greatest.
Thank you, boss. All right. Now, if you are going on a lunch date, I think these would be absolutely perfect. I could get you a shirt and something mango. Then some socks, you know, argyles maybe. Something not too loud, but this says, I'm here. What do you think, Mitch? Mitch!
Everybody, get ready for another road trip. This time, one of our newest Masketeers, Justin, is going to take us on a journey down home to Memphis, Tennessee.
Yo, what's up? This is where I come from. This is the Mississippi River, and that is Memphis, Tennessee. I come from the Memphis area, a town called Millington. Right now, we're in downtown Memphis. We just got the trolleys put in. I think they're really cool. And they go around and take you where you need to go so you don't have to drive. Hey, these are some of my friends. This is Trace, this is Nick, and this is Kyle. This is the famous Mud Island monorail, and it was used in the movie The Firm with Tom Cruise. It goes over the river, Mississippi River. When you get on the island, there's a mile-long walk. It's a model of the Mississippi River and rivers that connect to it. I'm at the amphitheater. This is where I come to see most of the concerts that come to Memphis. Yeah! Whenever I get a chance, I like to play golf. You know, it's one of my favorite sports. Right on the green. Thank you very much. It's a whole lot of fun. And sometimes there's a lot of competitiveness. The key to a good putt is to hit the ball in the little cup down there. And sometimes we just like to hit the ball and just have fun. Key to a good putt, in the hole. You know, it just wouldn't be Memphis without Elvis and Graceland. People just come in all the time just to see Graceland. They're fanatics, they're crazy, they just love Elvis. What brought you back this year?
Because we like it so much and went to see it as often as we can.
Elvis, Aaron, Presley. We got some Elvises here. We got a one in a blue shirt, one in a pink shirt, one in a white shirt. Thank you. Thank you very much. It's good to be here today, and I'd like to do a little tune for you. In my spare time, I like to relax and ride four-wheelers. I just love the feeling. The wind in your face, the speed of the road. Go to school, I come home, I play basketball. Home would be a place where I come to, where I have friends that I really know and that I really trust. It's peaceful and it's quiet. I just love it.
We're really excited about today's special Music Day guest.
So here singing his hit single, One Last Cry, is Brian Mcknight.
To my last prayer.
Let's hear one more time for Brian Mcknight.
Brian, you really get into your music. I saw a few tears here and there throughout your song. I was wondering, were you shocked at the huge success of One Last Cry?
I was definitely shocked. When I wrote the song, you know, I knew it was a great song at that time, but, you know, when I listened to the track, you know, there's nothing else on the radio that's like it. So I didn't know that the radio programmers would embrace it like they have. And you know what makes a hit? That they play it. The more you hear it, you get conditioned to it. And, you know, I'm just thankful to everybody for pulling together for the song.
Yeah, well, you also had a real big hit with Vanessa Williams. Now, how did you two get together for that song?
Well, we're on the same label. And when she was working on her Comfort Zone record, she asked me to help out on that record. So I worked on 7 or 8 of the songs on that record, producing and arranging and doing some other things. I actually wrote a duet on that record that we sang called You Gotta Go. And then Beverly Hills 90210 asked me to sing Love Is. And since she wanted to help my career, she consented to help me out with that, and that's how that came about. So,
are you planning on doing another album?
Well, I've got 6 more to do. I don't know really the time frame. I've actually more or less finished my next record, which will be out about March, but I'm just having fun making other people's records and, you know, touring and doing those sorts of things.
Now, you have so much soul, and, you know, when you sing, where do you get your inspiration for your music?
Well, I grew up listening to Stevie Wonder a lot. He's probably my biggest idol, I guess, if I was going to have an idol. But I still listen to Earth, Wind & Fire. I go back to the things I listened to as a kid. I don't really listen too much to the popular stuff that's out now, but I listen to the old stuff when I'm not in that spot where I need to be as a writer. So,
have you always wanted to be a singer?
I always wanted to be, but it's very difficult. There's so many people out there that want to do it. So I went to college, actually, to study computer science, and then I dropped out of school to do the music thing. But I guess it paid off.
Now, when you make an album, how do you decide whether to use a song that you wrote or somebody else's?
Well, what happened with this particular record, I probably recorded about 100 or 150 songs for this record. And when it came down to the last song, it needed to be up-tempo. And what I did was I thought about a lot of the old songs that I liked. And one of the songs was I Can't Go For That by Hall & Oates. And that's why I put that song on the record.
Will you sing I Can't Go For That for all of your new fans here?
Sure.
Y'all want to hear it? Here's Brian Mcknight, and I Can't Go For That.
Time.
Real soon.
Why? Because we like you.
Mouse Club is videotaped before a live audience at the Disney MGM Studios in Lake Buena Vista, Florida.